Thank you, colleagues. A point of order, Martin Whitfield.
I'm grateful, Presiding Officer, and it's really to seek your clarification as to whether the vote that is about to take place is in relation to suspending standing orders to allow an urgent question to be put in after the time, or whether the vote is to suspend standing orders to accept an urgent question to hear or at the next appropriate time for it to be responded to.
The vote before us will set aside Rule 13.8 of Standing Orders, well, its particular requirement that any urgent question be lodged before 10 a.m, so it will enable that timetable to be shifted. I hope that's clear. It sets aside the requirement that an urgent question be lodged before 10 a.m. So, the question is that Rule 13.8 of Standing Orders be varied to enable an urgent question to be lodged later than 10 a.m. today. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
Okay, I'm just going to ask that again because I wasn't entirely clear. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we will move to a vote and members should cast their votes now. The vote is closed. Point of order, Angus Robertson.
Into the online voting system, I would have voted no.
Thank you, Mr. Robertson. We'll ensure that's recorded. The result of the vote on the motion to vary standing orders in the name of Stuart McMillan is yes 49, no 55. There were no abstentions. The amendment is therefore not agreed. And we move on to point of order, Maggie Chapman.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Presiding Officer, I seek your guidance in relation to Section 7.5 of the Code of Conduct, that the requirement to treat each other with courtesy and respect. Given the repeated heckling from mainly men of mainly women who are on their feet answering questions, I refer specifically to an incident at Topical Questions earlier this afternoon, where Stephen Kerr's repeated interruptions of Minister Jenny Minto, what was designed, I can only imagine, to try and knock her off her feet. When, as a Parliament, we should be valuing and welcoming the contribution of women ministers, I'd welcome your guidance on this.
Thank you, Ms. Chapman, for your point of order. I believe that I dealt with the matter concerned at the time, and it is, I'm sure, no surprise to any member in here that I'm very determined that we will all treat one another with courtesy and respect at all times. Point of order, Mary McCallan.
Sir, just very briefly from me in respect to the previous vote with no motion, it was just to put on the record that the decision to terminate the contract of the former CEO has been a decision entirely for the board of Ferguson Marine, including the timing thereof. And as in respect of all matters with Ferguson Marine, I'll be very pleased to take questions from members at the appropriate time.
Thank Thank you. I'm sure the Cabinet Secretary is aware that while our comments are on the record, that is not a point of order. And we will now move on to the next item of business. I'll allow a moment or two for front benches to organise themselves.